No, you're okay.
どっち向けばいい？
So now I have a great pleasure to introduce Professor Kazuya Kato from Chicago University, and he will talk on height of motifs.
Thank you very much. So the partings defined the height of abelian varieties. Height of abelian varieties. A number abelian variety. Please, number he defined a height of abelian variety, and then by abelian variety of a number field, and he proved the Tate conjecture for homo of abelian varieties, and then. From this great result, he obtained other great results like the Konvich-Halevich conjecture, and then he proved model conjecture. That was in 1983, and I propose a definition of the height of motifs, motif over number field. And then we can imitate the argument of the Faltings, but still Tate conjecture cannot be proved because there is some finiteness which we cannot prove for motifs. So we can imitate some part of his argument. So I hope to explain such thing. So first I review the definition of the Faltings. So for simplicity, I will assume that the T is a rational number field Q. Then the definition of Faltings is the following. So let omega A be the case of differential forms over A, on A. Then this is isomorphic to F G, where G is the dimension of A. And then the inside here he has a space of integral differential forms. That is, here A is a zero module of A. So this is a integral version of it. This is over the group scheme over Z. And then he has so this space which is isomorphic to ZG. And then take an integral basis Z basis omega 1 to omega g of this integral space of differential forms. And then the height of A is defined as follows. This is omega, he has this integral, and then he has the definition of his height. And I hope to imitate this definition. Yeah. So by motif, I assume that is also written. We consider the we generalize this to motifs. But the first I first interpreted this by using the cohomology theory of motifs. First the omega this omega A is a part of field one in the general cohomology. So first we interpreted the using the cohomology theory of motifs. Cohomology theory. That is, so first, omega A appeared. This omega A is a field one of the Hodge filtration. This is F0, and F1 is omega A, and F2 is 0. So this F is a Hodge filtration. And then this omega 1 to omega g is if this exterior power is a basis of q base of determinant of omega a. This is the G3 power of omega A. And then that omega, in fact, the basis of object Z omega A. So you write this lambda then that integration AC. This is understood as this is lambda. We have this is a metric defined by using some that is Hodge metric. The metric defined by Hodge theory. And so the Hodge Durham cohomology appears and the Hodge theory appears. And for that some integrality should be defined on omega A. Yeah. So we do the similar thing, so let M be the pure motif. By pure motif, I mean that H M X Q R T. Yeah, this is T is this is some Q the X is a smooth projective over Q, and then T is a Z hat lattice, Z hat lattice, in H M Cuba, Italy, Zihatu, Artist. No, Tensa Cube, yeah. Yeah. So I understand this is some kind of integral the motif over Q, over pure motif over Q with Z coefficient. I just thought stable under Galois action. Stable under the Galois action. With Z coefficient. In general, for that, we usually take in the theory of motifs, pure motifs, we take some direct sum and of this, but for simplicity, I just take this as such pure motif. In general, we can take the direct sum and of this, but for simplicity, I discuss about this pure motif. Then we define the height of this. First, we have to consider such object. That is, we have M Durham, the Durham homology of this R twist. So we have Hodge field relation there. And then let L Q be the of this group. Determinant of Guru I tensor I. And then Guru I is the Fi divided by Fi plus 1. Here, F is the positive field ratio.
So you shift by R?
Yeah, this yes. In fact, that definition result, the height doesn't depend on the twist, so the Hateto twist, the natural way is that you shift by R, that the usual Hodge field ratio. But actually, the Hateto twist doesn't change the height. Yeah. Mm. And then, so the essential point is this, we take some tensor R i's power for that, so the Guru I contributes by the multiplicity I. Yeah. So then the Hodge metric can be defined on LQ. By my Hodge theory that I can soon explain, and then LZ inside LQ. This Q is isomorphic to LQ is isomorphic to Q, and LZ is isomorphic to Z. This is defined by using by periodic Hodge theory. And then we take Z basis of FZ. Then the Hodge height is defined to be the inverse of this Hodge metric. So what I have to, so I hope to explain this and this and then how we can imitate the method of partings. I hope to tell about the geometric analog. Then the number field, is similar to the compact Riemann surface. Or function field in gamma field, compact Riemann surface, maybe the function field in one variable over C. So if you then a motif over K, maybe and then this corresponds to a compact Riemann surface. And of course, we can consider motif over function field, but maybe in the analytic theory, it is nice to think about the variation of the structure. Maybe pure motif and variation of the structure over compact Riemann surface X, then you consider the variation of the structure over maybe. On X, then this I like by H. Yeah. Then the height of H is then the H HM should be similar to the following thing. That is the sum of degree of blue. R times the degree of blue R HO. Here, the variation of which structure which can have singularity. But by the theory of Durini, even if the Hodge structure has singularity, we can define a vector bundle called the bundle on X, the canonical extension of Green, that is the HO can be defined naturally on the open set of X where H has no singularity, but that extends canonically to the whole X by the theory of canonical extension of Green. And then this is because this is a vector bundle and the group R, if you take a, this is a Hodge filtration is there, and then you can take a group R. And then that is still a vector bundle, and so you can take a degree of the vector bundle, and then you take this, you multiply it by R. So that is this H, like log of HM is similar to this, and this thing was already considered by Griffiths and Peters and such people. so this thing is already in some studies. Yeah, so that this one is similar to that one. Yeah. Then I hope to. Yes. So now I hope to explain this. Concerning the integrality here, integral structure, the my present definition is not so beautiful, and so then too much complicated, so I just explain the love story about this, because
same as yours. Yeah. We don't hear you. Wait.
There's a question, sorry.
Yes, okay, please.
So I want to ask a technical question about the height. So the usual height, so there are two variants of this, because the canonical extension in the case of a rational exponent, so it's not compatible with duality, tensor products, etc. extension of the.
Oh yeah 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 yeah. So
the version where you ramify so that it becomes unipotent monodromy or.
Oh maybe please assume that with the unipotent monodromy yeah. I am talking about this, not thinking so well. Yeah. Yes.
Make it semi-stable, but you have to also in
the other coach theory, that may be, but far things define the height without assuming that it is semi-stable. So, but in the actual argument, then he always assumes that the abelian varieties have a semi-stable reduction in his main argument. So I am not sure if the case of the definition of the height for non-semi-stable thing is defined nice or I'm not so sure about this. Probably the good way is to define heights only for object features. I assume that this is in LQ. Then S, but C tensor LQ is by Hodge theory then C tensor Q H Brown is isomorphic to C tensor. HM X C Q. And this one has the integral structure. The coming from the T. Yeah. HM X. Yeah, I neglect the twist, sorry. Q. Maybe you have to take R twist. This is just usual R twist. Yeah. And then this one is if it, also a graded quotient of this H drum MX is by this isomorphism then this is isomorphic to maybe HR M minus R. And this is the T. This is C tensor F R and tensor F M minus R bar. This bar is...
You want R or R?
Sorry.
R でいいんですか? I じゃなくていいんです
か? Oh, yeah, I was using I, sorry. Maybe I is confusing with the I in the la complex number eyes. Mm. Yeah, but maybe that taru should be also eye. Mm. Yeah, and so this is bias taken with respect to this rational structure. Yeah, so this is the usual thing for Hodge theory. Yeah, and then this is a element of so. This is an element of C tensor Q of no. determinant of H I C M minus I tensor I. Yeah. By this, there is a canonical isomorphism. Yeah, the map is probably from this side to this side, but then by Hodge theory, then you have isomorphism. So HC, if you like HC, this is HC. HC is like sum of HIC minus I. This is a Hodge decomposition. Yeah. So then S tensor is biased inside determinant of H C I M minus I, and the bar changes the I and G and this indices. So then you have bias inside this det C H minus I C. And if this tensor. So if you replace this I by M minus I, then this is equal to determinant of C H I M minus I C tensor M minus I. Just I is replaced by M minus I, so then you have this. Yeah. Then you take that tensor product of this, then you have I and determinant of H I C M minus I, and then you have I plus M minus I is M, so you have M, and then this. But then this is the tensor product of determinant is the determinant of the direct sum. So you have this, and so then you have the Hodge decomposition tells that the whole value sum of those things are equal to HC. HC is, you have an integral structure, so HC is a C tensor with a integral structure HC, and so you have this is a C tensor determinant Z HC, and then you have tensor M. Now here you have the basis Z basis here. You have Z basis here, Z basis, and then you have the metric is defined to be the just S tensor S bar divided by C, and you can write S tensor is Z E. Here Z is a complex number, so the metric is defined to be to the square root of Z. So this defines the metric on L2. Now, next thing is to define the integral structure. And my definition is too much complicated at present. So I am maybe it is not so good to explain the details because if I start with the details, then that will finish my talk. So now the integral concerning LZ, then we have to define LZ's the such ZP thing, intersection with ZP thing. So it is enough to define this for each P, P prime. And then now we use the periodic Hodge theory. So by periodic Hodge theory, the B-drum tensor, periodic Hodge theory tells that B-drum tensor H-drum in X is isomorphic to B-drum tensor HM XC Q or eta QP. Yes. And so then we have a integral structure here, the integral structure here. So TP, T is TP. And so TP is here. And that is then if you take the drum functor that is the drum functor is or Galois stable part. Take a Galois stable QP bar fixed part. Then you have a QP tensor H drum MX is equal to this. By definition, it is B drum of this VP. VP is a QP tensor. This drum is just defined to be the fixed part of the whole theory. This is really VP. The drum is the Galois variant of this. Yeah, fixed part. Yeah. But it is not clear how we can define our integral structure by using the integral structure TP. In my opinion, the integrality in the periodic Hodge theory is still not yet in the best situation. And so we wonder how to transport the integral structure TP to the integral structure here. In the good case, is a content Raphael theory. If Hodge filtration satisfies if X is of good reduction. X is of good reduction at P, and the Hodge filtration has a nature that FA is Hodge drum and FA plus P minus Y is zero, then you have a then for such was for such yeah crystalline representation VP then you have a functor D PP is defined and the such thing is exact and for such things and then the each TP TI this is a FI of TP the Hodge filtration the Hodge filtration on this side is defines the Hodge filtration on this in the gram VP. The integral thing is defined. And then you can use this integral structure to define the LZP. LZP is just the LQ and then in fact this is LZP is defined to be the tensor product of Guru I D T get ZP Guru I D T tensor I yes and this is in LQP and so then LZP is defined to be the LQP and LZP and LQ inside LQP. So in this case you can define the integral structure in this way. But in general if X has bound reduction at P then it is a very delicate problem to define an integral structure on the tram side. So my current definition is not so beautiful. So I probably it is better to move to the introduction to the how to imitate to explain how to imitate the parting science. So I have some preprint in archive I don't know if so so in the QP of Galois cohomology and VP are twisted. And then because you have an integral structure H1 QP TP R by using this integral structure then you can define some integral structure from by using this integral structure here. This is so I defined the integral structure by such method and in fact if V is VP A of the abelian variety then or such case then the Martin's definition the result is coincide with the definition of the integral structure of Martin's. But I think it is the precise thing is too much complicated around here. So the method is roughly like this. My present method is roughly like this. But I imagine that there is a better method to define the integral structure there. My definition is too much complicated or too strange, and so this is not so good to define to study the family of motifs. So this works, my method works only for individual motifs, and so if you consider that you like to study the family of motifs, then this my method is not so good. And so I hope that there should be some good method which works for a family of motifs or a family of variations of variations of periodic representations or something. But I'm sorry, I stopped this. So, and then I explain how to imitate other things. Hartings in his proof of the data conjecture for homomorphisms of Abelian varieties. And then also I explain we can imitate some part. He had two things to prove the one thing is that he has a some AM isogeny to AN, then height AN are bounded. And another thing is that the Abelian varieties are height is finite. He is dimension G and G is fixed and he assumes that is semi-stable reduction everywhere. And what I omit such such thing exists here. And the reason for this reason is that his height is his height is essentially equal to the height of the this is so I have to explain a little more. That is this is because HA is essentially equal to the H of the A where A is the point of
you think some polarization?
Oh yeah, the polarization should be fixed. Yeah. So I am neglecting such point. Yeah. And for so then it is well known that if you have a algebraic variety, then on that space, the rational point, if you fix bound, you have a if you fix some C, then there are only finitely many rational points on the algebraic variety of the height smaller than C. So this is not equal, but similar to this. So Hartings proved that his height is almost nearly equal to the height of the point A. Which is a point of the modular space of Abelian varieties. Yeah. So by this then he proved this. And what is this AN is that he needed to prove that he needed to prove that if you have a exact sequence like this and then this is Galois Q cube. So I am now assuming K is cube for simplicity. W stable subspace in P. Then the key point of the proof is key point of the proof of home state conjecture. For Abelian varieties. For Abelian varieties. I have not yet introduced state conjecture. Yeah. State conjecture is that home of VP, Galois Q, VP, A, VP, B, C, is equal to 2. Or TPA, is equal to ZP, tensor Z. This is reduced to the case A is B, and the key point is to show that for such things, then there is some if in QP tensor and A such that if VP A is W. Yeah. And then the consider the integral version TPA sum W ZP, sorry. This is some ZP version of this. Then the TPAN is AN is a Abelian variety which is isogenous to A such that TPAN is P to Z N T P A plus W Z P. And so then this is you have a morphism from and then he proved these two things by this then, because isomorphism, there are only finitely many isomorphism classes in these AN, so he has many isomorphism things, the isomorphisms the isomorphisms are, so that he found many, because there are only finitely many isomorphism classes, so then those isomorphisms, assume for simplicity in zero is assume that for simplicity this is by replacing a by an one by a, then assume that all those are isomorphic to a, then you have many isomorphisms, many isogeny from A to A, and you have a FN. And then by replacing the set of NI by some infinite subset of those NI, then you have this, you have a limit in ZP tensor. This is endomorphism. So by those you have many isomorphisms, and then you can find many non-trivial isogeny, and then you have many non-trivial elements in end A. Then so the big problem. So here the problem B is assumed to be A here, and then the problem is that you should find the some many elements of the end A. But the such thing is obtained by in this way. So if you take, you can, this is a compact space. So you have the sum, if you replace those in set of NI by some infinite subset, then you can have the convergence. And so then this F, then because this EPA is such a thing, then n goes to infinity, then this becomes zero, so the EPA becomes WZP. Because the limit of this is WZP. So that was his method. And so then I cannot imitate this part. But I can imitate this part. This part is this is because here we needed we use the fact that there is a modular space of an abelian variety. But for motifs there is no modular space in general of motifs. So this part is cannot be imitated. I cannot imitate this part, but this is okay. So then I hope to imitate that part. Yeah. So that is the consequence is that if we have such finiteness for motifs, then we can prove the Tate conjecture. That the Tate conjecture is that Tate conjecture for motifs is that the ZP from MN is. N is isomorphic to home of the GQ of NP. This is so if M is HMX QR and T, then this NP means just DP. So the consequence is that I hope to explain how we can imitate this part. Yeah. And so then that is so the consequence is that the if such motif high beam is finite, the motif, but with fixed Hodge numbers. Motif over Q. In that sense, the integral, such integral motif with integral structure is finite. Then the Tate conjecture, then this Tate conjecture is true. By the same argument. So I hope to explain how we can imitate that part. So assume that M is like that, and we are given a subjection U, and then U prime Galois table, Galois Q table in P, and then M is MX alpha simplicity So MP means just the P component of TP. And then we hope to prove that then let MN be the MN be HM X Q R TN. Here TN is a kernel of T to U P to Z in U. And then, yes, so that is TPM is equal to P to Z in TP plus U prime. Yes, in the same way as it. Yes. So, So then, then what we have we hope to prove is that so then in yeah then assume that keys of good reduction sorry I have images of good reduction at p and then for there is some A such that if A is the totals in H drum and A plus P minus 1 is A. Yeah, assume this. Then what we can prove then H and M is independent of M. And how to prove this is just similar to the proof of Harding. The proof is the following. So we have a exact sequence. So let you have EP or MP to MP UP. And then you have an exact sequence by the theory of container file like this. And then you have a graded quotient R also exact sequence like this. And so then now let T be the S be the S be the dimension so V is P tensor U. And so dimension V, this is a, and then this is a weight and the dimension, and then T is, T is the sum of R graded R T gram V, I, Then, the general fact is that S equals T. Yeah. We have this. This is true for any such V. V is a global Galois representation. Yeah. And then for a global Galois representation, which is of weight M and which is drum at P. And so with M representation, then you have S equals T. Yeah, this is reduced to the case because SV is equal to the depth of V, and TV is equal to T of depth of V, and depth V is isomorphic to QP M for some M over because this is a one dimensional representation so you have this isomorphism over some number over T over some T minor and then in this case, S determinant V is equal to this is minor. That in one then confusing, so I like this. Then this is minus N, and T is also minus M. Yeah. This is guru I multiplied by I works very well here.
Yeah.
And so then if you compare this ratio of the height, then it is equal to n tv divided by t n s v, and this is 1. Yeah. The reason is that if you compare these two, then on the Fauchi side, then you define the metric by using the integral structure here, but that changes a little. Yeah. And for the definition, then you define the difference. So the this is the index is equal to, yeah, so sorry, so the index here is equal to index is equal to 2 this 2 times tv, this v, yeah. Yes, because the difference comes from v, so the difference comes, in the difference of n and n comes from the, yeah, so hz divided by hz, n is equal to u divided by dz, and so from this then the rank of this u and the tensor with tensor m comes from this in this way, and the metric and on the other hand the metric difference of the integral structure comes from this u, and then the u of v, then the difference of the integral structure is like this. So the in the definition of the height, then you define the integral, you use the integral structure and the metric, and the integral structure changes by this, and the metric changes by this, so that they cancel, and so that there is no difference. So this is a proof of that independence. So then if this is finite, then by the same argument, I have to stop here. And then I did not explain the mixed motif, height of mixed motifs, and in that, so and then I then and I could not explain the how the this story is related to the story of degeneration of which structures. If you consider the family, I just finished some if for a motif over curve over number field, then the formula is that if you take the HNP is in H is the log of the height. So at each point then you have a specialization of the motif, and then you consider the height. Then this is something like the geometric height times such a thing can be proved in certain cases for mixed motifs, and such thing is, and then again the geometric and integral structure, I don't know, geometric is contributes to the theory contributes to the Archimedean part of the height, and then to prove such a formula, then we have to study the designation of the Hodge structure at the point of the singularity. I have no time.
I have to finish. Yes.
Are there any questions? First, from Paris.
So, can you compute the height of the motif attached to an eigenform?
Sorry.
Can you hear me?
I'm sorry.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Could you repeat the question?
Can you compute the height of the motif attached to an eigenform?
Modular form.
Yeah.
You mean modular form? That is a hard question, yeah. And today there is a big progress in Langlands correspondences. So such thing should be studied from the side of modular forms, I think, yeah. Yeah, but I never studied this such thing. Really, it is very nice to think about the automorphic form side of this story. I have no idea about this.
So I have a question, but I think it's mainly about recalling old facts. So in the case of Faltings, I think it was known before that the Galois representation is semi-simple, if I recall correctly.
I assume that the motif here, pure motif, is polarizable. So I think the semi-stability follows from that thing. That semi-simplicity is, I think, is a result of the
Bogomolov.
I once thought about this, and then semi-simplicity was okay. Because we can assume that the motif has, we assume that the motif has polarization. Yes. Then, I think that is okay. I cannot tell the reason so well here.
So another question related to this attack conjecture. So of course there is the question of semi-simplicity on the side of motifs. So Janssen proved that even homological and numerical equivalence, I think, are the same. Does it follow from the Tate conjecture homological and numerical equivalence are the same? Maybe it's well known, but can you recall what is known about?
I am not so sure. I'm not so sure I don't. I cannot answer very about this question. Semi-simplicity is a question, some problem, yes. And I'm sorry, my brain is not working so very well. So I hope to think about it later, but I'm sorry. At present, I cannot answer. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I sold for Paris.
So, any questions or comments from Beijing?
So, are there special cases where the finiteness assumption is satisfied?
That is so. If the four motifs which have some modular space, then that may be okay. But for other cases, I am not so sure. Yeah, I don't have anything about the finiteness. I have no idea. I have no result about the finiteness.
Questions? So there are no more questions from Beijing.
So, any questions or comments from Tokyo?
So you can formulate the analog of Voigt's conjecture for four motifs.
Some Voigt the log P pair P M has bad reduction at P. And then you have to compare the height of M, and then the Voigt's conjecture for motif version, the motif version of the Voigt's conjecture is something like this. We have to put some coefficient, and it is not clear what is a good coefficient here. We have questions. What is this? Thus, roughly speaking, the Voigt's conjecture is should have for motifs should have such shape. Roughly speaking. And what should be E or what thing should be discussed. And also a geometric analog of this should be considered to decide E. I have some rough attempt. I made some rough attempt about this, some study can be done here.
Any other questions or comments? Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
この後歓迎会あるんですけども、